Joining me now is Roger Apollon Jr. He is the head of Four City Brewing Company. Hey, man, welcome. How are you?
I'm doing well. Very, very excited to be on. Thanks for having me.
So, Roger, tell me, first of all, nobody's opening new businesses in Orange, New Jersey. You are this pioneer. You're like, I'm doing it. Tell me what inspired it, and let's talk about beer.
Let's talk about beer, right. So Four City Brewing was really the brainchild or the outgrowth of a beer tasting group that I started informally in my neighborhood. I live in West Orange, and me and my partner, Jeff Gattins, and my other partner, Anthony Minervino, we're all West Orange residents. And we would meet at my house monthly and exchange craft beer. And it started off very scholarly. You know, we take tasting notes.
I love it.
You know, and talk about the bouquet and all this.
Yeah.
By three beers in, we're just like, oh, this is great. It got all raucous, you know.
I love it.
You know, it was just a hobby.
Yeah.
And from that, it became this, you know, now we're looking for new breweries to go to. Now we're checking out different beers. Now we have people going to Vermont and bringing back beers. We have people going to Belgium and bringing back beers.
Wow.
So this was going on for about 15 years. And then right around 5 or 6 years ago, people started asking us, you know, do you guys brew beer? And we're like, no, we just have these tastings. It's kind of fun. And then by the third or fourth person who asked us if we brew beer, I'm like, you know, people think we brew beer already. We might as well start a brewery. So that's kind of
– love it.
That's kind of how
How'd you get the money? Now, what kind of job did you have? Did you quit your job? And you're like, I got to go raise some money, max out credit cards? How'd you do it?
No. We're all still gainfully employed at our full-time jobs. I'm a
school kidding.
Teacher.
Ah, it's awesome.
Yes.
Awesome.
My partner Anthony is a fireman in Bloomfield.
Wow.
And Jeff is a technology guy. He lives in New Jersey as well. So we all have our full-time jobs because we have families.
You guys are awesome. That's the best part of the story. I didn't know that. I love that.
Yeah.
Love it.
Yeah. We just, we were very naive. We came up with a business. Our first business plan was, I think, maybe 2 pages long with a spreadsheet attached. And we were just like going to people like, give us money. And they were, you know, ripping it up and laughing.
Right.
Not a business plan.
Right.
So we had to really educate ourselves on the business of a brewery. So we wrote a real business plan, which took about a year to write. And then we just got, again, this is a community thing. We just asked our friends and family to support us. And we have 20 investors who all live in the area from Maplewood to Orange and South Orange and Milburn and New York City. And they believed in us. And that's how we raised our money to get this started. So this is not just the three of us. There's 23 people behind this brewery, and they're all locally based people who love craft beer.
It's such a great Jersey story. It's why I wanted you to join me this morning. I mean, our audience is just like, we're looking for that good news. And I tell people, that's why I'm digging in. I love New Jersey. It's why I'm not going anywhere. You know, we've got a great state. Now, just tell me quick, how tough was the bureaucracy to deal with our government?
The bureaucracy is challenging, and you know what? I want to be the bridge, because I think there's this fake war or fake misunderstanding between the restaurant and bar lobby and breweries. I think the media sometimes creates this animosity.
No, Roger, you can say it. The media is terrible. I take myself out of that. As I'm lucky as an opinion guy, but I get mad as much as anything because it's all about ad space. It's all about let me see if I can get that clickbait going. It makes me crazy because they thrive on the negative. And that's why I wanted you to come on, because I'm like, no, there's a real positive here. This dude started a company, and I can't wait to try the beer. You
oh
know,
my gosh.
That is my hint. If you guys want to send some, that'd be cool with us.
Trust me, as soon as we're ready to can beer and get it out there, you guys will be the first to get them. Or even maybe a sixth, but we'll talk about
it. We'll do a little drinking sometimes in the morning on our Fridays. Sometimes.
What's wrong with that? It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
That's right.
But I think this bit of animosity is created, and I think it stems from miseducation.
Yeah.
Honestly,
typically does.
Our education came from going to Vermont, going to places where craft beer on the West Coast and the South were thriving. And we see restaurants right next to a brewery, right next to a bar, and they're all packed because there's a synergy. And I think in New Jersey, they're starting to understand that craft beer is actually going to make New Jersey a destination, a town, a destination again. Now, people talk about making America great again. What's made America great in the past was every town had their own butcher, their own baker.
You're speaking volumes. That's right.
Right?
Yeah.
That's, you know, you can go to any town and I can go to this town in Ohio and that I'm not going to get bread like that from a town baker in Montclair because that it's only made.
Roger.
And the guy who owns that bakery, he lives on my street. The kids go to my school. And you know what? That's what makes America great again.
I'm 100% with you, Roger. And that's why in terms of tax policy, regulatory burden, government needs to be there to help make every town great again. Orange,
exactly.
West Orange, South Orange, right?
Exactly.
So listen, I got to jump. I'm out of time, but I want to ask you real quick. I would love to have you back on because this battle is brewing, no pun intended, between restaurants and the different lobbyists and the lawyers. But your story is fantastic. Let me just ask you real quick. When are you going to be open for people to come visit and try the beer?
We are aiming for the end of this month. Unfortunately, we can't give you an exact date.
Okay.
We're still waiting for some local ordinances to go through. Hopefully that'll happen this week. But at the end of this month, definitely we're aiming for before Labor Day.
Great. Are you guys on Twitter?
At this point.
Are you on Twitter?
We're on Twitter. We're on Instagram.
What are you on
Twitter? We're at Four City Brewing.
All right. I'm going to tag you. I'll send this out and I'll tag your website and do me a favor. You talked to producer Kristen this morning. Please call us the day before you open. I want to make a big announcement.
We definitely will. You'll be the first to know. And thank you so much for supporting us. We really appreciate the positivity.
You got it, man. Have a great rest of your day. Good luck, Roger. Thank you.